Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about the death of SDK-less mediation networks. All right, so last week, AdMob sent through an email saying that on May 25th, the same day that GDPR kicks in, we should talk about that at some point. On May 25th, they are discontinuing support for SDK-less mediation networks. So I did a video about this a couple years ago, back when, you know, when it was still fairly new, all about SDK-less mediation. And for those of you who've never used it or don't know, it's like being able to use mediation for other networks besides AdMob through AdMob mediation, but not having to include all the different SDKs. So like if you were gonna have Facebook Audience Network through your AdMob mediation, you have to include all the SDKs for Facebook and all the other different ones that you use, and that kind of bloats the size of your application. And if you have like a, the thing I thought was really fantastic about SDK-less mediation was that, like, I use Corona SDK on a lot of applications, and Corona SDK only supported AdMob and a few other networks. So using something like an SDK-less mediation network meant I could just use like a bunch of different networks too. Although there were only like four different SDK-less mediations, and one of them was Smaato, S-M-A-A-T-O. And I think I've spoken about it once before. So it was a fantastic idea, SDK-less mediation networks, but the downside was they all sucked, right? I've never heard anybody talk about how great they were. Like, from, like, the email said that, you know, you still have Smaato set up on some of your apps, right? It's so bad. Smaato is so bad that I didn't even realize I had them set up. You know, still, I thought I disabled them, but you know, I checked and I still do have some of them set up. They just don't make any money at all, right? So, you know, so I was really hoping that would work. It's terrible. For years I've been trying to make the mediation thing work a bit better, and I've only have like three different networks. I got AppLovin, AdMob, and Facebook Audience Network. And sometimes I'll shut off AppLovin for a while if it gets too low and it's just siphoning off, money when it gets really low. So anyway, what they're replacing it with, is called AdMob Open Bidding. And to be honest with you, I didn't even know anything about it. I guess it was announced like on the 22nd of March. And this is like another way of doing things, a bit like SDK-less mediation, except it's done through open bidding. So rather than relying on historical eCPMs, so the CPMs go up and down, you know, and it relies on the past performance, it's going to rely on the bids. So you'll get bids from different networks and they would automatically take the highest bid. So sounds fantastic. I need to start using that thing. So it sounds like there's a lot of innovation going on there, and I'm really kind of excited about it. So like I said, I've been trying to get mediation to work better for years. One of the things I did like early on was that when I found out that, you know, you can set up all these different mediation networks, and so the highest one will go to. So if AdMob happens to be low, you go with AppLovin. If AppLovin happens to be low, you go with ChartBoost or whatever the different ones are, right? There's so many ad networks that you've never heard of. It's like, yeah, it's like going to a festival where you've heard of a few bands, but most of them you don't. That's what ad networks are like. Some of them are just so minor that there's just like a few tentpole ones. Anyway, So early on, I went through and I set up like ad networks for, I set up all the SDKs for like 10 different ad networks to set up mediation. And what I found was all of a sudden I wasn't hardly getting any money because it was all going off into all these different directions. And I was having these little pockets of money, you know, in different networks. And it was always like lower than the monthly threshold. So like it would be like every couple months that I get paid from them. And eventually I just go turn them all off. And I had to go remove all the SDKs too. And the thing about including the SDKs in your application, it's not just the SDKs, it's not the size and everything. They usually have permissions that need to be added and everything like that. It's just a hassle. So hopefully it'll continue going into the SDK-less way, even though they're not supporting the official, it's tough to say, SDK-less mediation networks. But you know, anyway, I think it's gonna be pretty cool. I'm gonna have to look into that thing. Oh, one thing. I'll talk about this more in more detail in a future episode. I just We just removed every single free app from Apple on our App Store, and we're just going with paid apps, with the exception of EarSpy, because that's the only one that's really been making money lately, and we're trying to decrease the amount of apps. So I won't be able to test it out on Apple ads, but we will test it out on Google. So anyway, just thought I'd talk a little bit about that today. I mean, hey, how many of you guys, tell me, because I could be wrong about this, have you used SDK-less Mediation while it still existed, and did it ever support you? Did you ever make any money from it? Because I've talked to a lot of developers who never have. And are you using open bidding yet? I'm not even sure if it's available yet. But are you using it, and how are you finding it to work for you? Because I'd be really interested in knowing that too. Anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.